Next, we're going to measure the density of gravel. Gravel is an irregular shaped object, so we're going to need a new method to measure density. I'm going to start by weighing my weighing paper, and that weighs 0.410 grams. I'm going to fold my weighing paper into quarters so it can make an indentation at the bottom. So when I pour some rocks in here, we want between 20 and 25 grams. So I'm going to add some rocks to my paper and then get the mass of the paper plus the rocks. So that's about 23.235 grams. Next, I want to get the volume of my rocks that I measured the mass of. In order to do that, I'm going to take a graduated cylinder, a 50 ml graduated cylinder, and I'm going to add deionized water to about 25 ml. What's important here is you record the exact volume. Whenever you're reading the bottom of the meniscus of your water, that's the curvature part. You want to make sure you're looking where the top of the line, where it's touching. You want to read that at eye level. So I am bending down at eye level to look at it, or I could lift it up and look at my eye level. So when I read this, this is 20, and then here's my mark at 25. It's between 25 and 26. So I'm going to estimate a decimal place. I'm going to call that 25.8 milliliters. You want to record the initial volume exactly. Your procedure says about 25 mLs, but you need to record that exact volume. Now what we're going to do is we're going to transfer our gravel into the graduated cylinder. And I want to do this at an angle so that I add it in slowly so I don't splash any of the water out of my graduated cylinder. And I also want to make sure if there's any air bubbles that are accumulating, which I can see happening, that I tap this to get those air bubbles out, because we want to account for the correct volume change. And if we have air bubbles in there, that will affect it. So I'm tapping it a little bit to make sure I get all the air bubbles out. And so you can see our water level has risen, and this is due to the volume of the rocks. So this is how we can calculate the volume of the rocks, is by what we call water displacement. So our water level has risen. We want to include the volume of the new water level. So this is 20, 30, this is 30. 35. It looks like it's just below 35, so it's between 34 and 35 mLs. And again, I'm going to estimate where the bottom of the meniscus. So I'm going to call this 34.8 milliliters is what I'm reading on my graduated cylinder. And now by subtracting the difference of my two volumes, I can calculate the volume of the rocks.